back to my channel. As you can see, today I have Deja. I don't know if this is your first time making a channel. Like, officially. I mean, we have the prom video.
Yeah, maybe officially, yeah.
Yeah, so officially, yeah. Officially,
we're gonna collab.
Fucking collab, you're my friend. So this is Deja, if you haven't known, she has a YouTube channel as well, and we're gonna do videos on her channel, and all the information will be down below. But today, as you can tell from the title, we're doing a would you rather. We have some food right here. We have fries and
bacon balls.
So yeah, we're gonna be answering questions. I don't have any planned out, so it's kind of just from, you know, randomly. So yeah, let's just get to the video.
It's starting off ridiculous. Oh my god. Would you rather watch your parents have sex every day for the rest of your life or join in once to make it stop?
Bruh.
Why did you ask that?
Because I saw it on Google. It spoke to me.
I would never ever join in with sex with my parents.
Okay. So you're watching your parents have sex every day for the rest of your life?
Every day. Okay. So a couple seconds a day. Okay. I'm gonna peek in.
Okay.
How do I join in my family?
I don't know how. It was your question.
You're disgusting. Would you rather lose your sense of feeling during sex or lose your sense of taste forever?
Taste. Because I can be the healthiest motherfucker on planet Earth.
So forever you can't, like, nothing. Every day it tastes like water.
I could eat kale forever, live forever. Yes, I would eat healthy. Because nothing would taste bad to me. Flax seeds and stuff like that. Yeah.
No, it's like, no, lose
yes,
your taste.
Yes, I can't taste anything. I can't taste anything. I will be so healthy. Artichokes.
Spinach.
Yes, easy. Come on. No. The sense of touch. That's crazy.
Just the taste?
Mm-mm.
You have to decide you'll be. No, psychologically, imagine how sad you'll be. If you can't taste nothing. You can never taste.
I know what I traded for. I know what I traded for.
But you know what? You don't do it every day.
I
love food.
Would you rather lick a homeless man's toe or chew a piece of gum you found sticking? Would you rather lick a homeless man's toe or chew a piece of gum you found under a random table, like out somewhere? I know what I say.
Chew a piece of gum.
Really? I'll lick that damn toe.
Gum? You're really. Gum, you're all up in that, like somebody's mouth. And you're.
Fungus! Foot fungus!
Oh, no.
Warts, dirt.
I licked that toe.
Warts, dirt.
Someone chew gum.
It could be me, though. You don't know.
It's just random.
Yeah, but you know.
No one's going to pick a lick to be. It's just a.
But you said a lick a toe. Suck a toe, lick a toe.
I'm going to put somebody else's gum. I put your gum in my mouth before.
Yeah, exactly.
But random, you don't know.
But you don't know.
Mouth.
So if you think of it, it's like less to think about than looking at a dirty ass foot and looking at foot. Look at that toe.
I look at that toe.
Oh my god.
It will take a lot, but it had to be done.
Lick it, not just like a lick. You have to lick, suck that toe.
I didn't say that.
No, if I have to chew gum, you have to suck a toe. You have to suck a toe if you chew gum. You have to suck.
But like, as I'm chewing gum and getting herpes. That's nasty.
God.
This is on steroids. Look at the ass of the camera. Viewers, Google is asking, would you rather drink a cup of your mom's period blood or a cup of your dad's semen? Comment below. That can be asked. Because I wouldn't have answered for you. Is it penalty death for not choosing either or? Because I couldn't answer that.
Semen is absolutely no. I'd rather drink the blood.
Yeah, at the end of the day, but fuck.
Semen? A cup?
No.
I must have threw up in my mouth. Would you rather not have sex for a year or have it every day of your life but not orgasm ever?
I haven't had sex in 18 years. That's my answer.
I was talking about, if you ever sexually active, on a regular basis, you had to give up sex for a whole entire year, or have sex every day but never orgasm from it.
Every day for a year?
Every day for the rest of your life.
I'll take the year off. Sometimes it's best to just take the time off and get back to where you need to be. I'm taking the time off. No, ma'am. Would you rather have an obvious orgasm every time you're next to someone you find attractive, or never have an orgasm again in your life?
Automatic. That's just my attractive.
Really? Like a obvious orgasm.
Someone might think
like someone messy. Nuts in your face, like. That's ridiculous.
Never again.
No. Gonna have an obvious orgasm in somebody's face every time you find somebody attractive.
So you're having never again in your life to feel that feeling.
Every time you see someone.
I don't know if I attract someone attractive all the time. How rare is that? I look at someone and I'm like, damn, they're sexy as fuck. I don't do that all the time. Would you rather wear someone's dirty underwear, like dirty discharge underwear?
Oh fuck.
Or use your toothbrush, like. I was talking about.
Toothbrush.
So you want to use someone's gum? I'm not talking someone you know. You don't use someone's gum, but you use someone's.
My vagina.
No, you wouldn't choose someone that chose gum, but you someone that brushed their tongue, scrape off the plaque, the tongue, the morning, the dirt.
Let me tell you something.
The saliva. See, so you guys.
Faucet water gets hot.
No.
Yes.
Discharge underwear. I couldn't do it. My vagina would be crying all day. I would hear it crying.
What would you say?
That's my question. Move on.
Would you rather only being able to have sex in 5 minute increments for the rest of your life or only being able to have sex in 5 hour increments for the rest of your life?
5 minutes, quick and sweet.
Quick and sweet for the rest of your life?
Quick and sweet. 5 hours? You're not gonna be super. You're sure gonna be super.
5 minutes? You will never get more than 5 minutes for the rest of your life. Increment.
5 hours? Imagine being in a state for 5 entire hours. 5 hours. Your vagina's gonna be done. Sore, pounded, your uterus is gonna hurt. You're gonna be so loose. You'll be so loose. 5 hours of heaven. You know how loose you'll be? You wouldn't be enjoyable anymore.
Damn.
5 hours, you will not be enjoyable. You'll be loose. No, it took about 5 minutes. You have to learn how to pound it out.
Quick and sweet?
How many? 2 minutes and 30 seconds per person. If you can't get it done, then...
That's on you.
Would you rather spend a day wearing wet socks, like soaking wet socks, or spend a day with popcorn kernels stuck into your gums and your teeth? Like, no.
Wet socks. Where's the professional dentist every time I need to get the popcorn on my teeth?
Getting shit out.
No.
Wet socks.
Yup.
That's the worst feeling in the world.
Yup. Better than popcorn? That's nasty. That's awful. That's an awful feeling.
It's not that bad.
And I know it never goes away. The minute you forget it, it comes back. I think it's gonna be my last sex question. Would you rather never have sex again or never have internet access again? That's nuts.
No.
Internet
access. I love connection between, not even like sex, like connection between people. And not even like sex, like connection between like
you can people. Connect with people, but there's no sex, but you have internet.
I'm talking about internet. I can get away internet for family or for sex. Like, it's not that serious. People can tell me what's going on, important stuff in the world. I can talk to people. I can talk to people, see what's going on. I don't have to physically look at it. Would you rather be constantly itchy, or be constantly sticky? Always, even itchy or sticky, there's always something going on.
Naturally, when I scratch myself in public, I feel like a filthy bitch. I feel like I'm a dirty bitch if I scratch myself in public.
I'll be sticky all the time. Sticky, like, somebody can really see that you go, like, sticky like you.
If I have a itch right here in public, I will do it real quick. I will not stand there and scratch myself like a dirty dog. Sticky. That's awful.
Sticky? I can never. Sticky is one of the worst things. That's like putting syrup on your skin.
Imagine always being itchy, like always scratching and. Like you have ticks.
I'm about to tell people I have psoriasis.
Please.
Huh? What was that word?
I don't know. It's a pH.
Psoriasis.
Yeah.
Fuck.
I'm gonna tell people I have psoriasis. Or I have eczema.
You have to play back psoriasis.
I'm
eczema sweatshirt. You have to rip eczema.
Yeah, I'm not gonna be sticky.
I have eczema, I'm not dirty.
I don't like being sticky. If I'm sticky, I will take an instant shower. I do not like it.
Damn, imagine showering and can't get unsticky. Fuck my brain. It messed me up.
Who was that girl who was talking about she had a fear of syrup? I had a fear of syrup because they spilled all over them as a kid.
That's crazy.
They were so sticky and the prints in the bathtub and they couldn't get it off. They were in the bathtub for hours. They could not get the layers of syrup off of them.
Would you always have visibly and like you can feel it, chapped lips all the time? Or rather be visibly ashy all the time?
Visibly ashy. I can't have chapped lips. I'm gonna be fucking sick animal.
You'd rather be a black woman visibly ashy.
Sometimes I was never in the night and moisturize my lips.
You'd rather be a black woman visibly ashy all the time. You're always an ashy bitch. No matter how bad bitch your outfit is, you're ashy.
I can't imagine walking around all day with my
Because you can still like put on matte lipstick and just be chapped. You can always look chapped. But you can be moisturized.
So my lips look crusty?
Chapped.
No. Chapped is crust.
So your outfits are always something where you can hide your ash. Mm-hmm. So you wear pink long sleeves in the summer and always hide your ash.
If I sweat, then rub the sweat into my skin. I'm ashy.
And there you
have it. How do I sit outside purposely before I go somewhere to sweat?
Babe, you need to sweat.
I need to sweat because I need
But then you wipe your pits so you don't stink. And you lotion with your sweat. Because lotion doesn't work for you. Oil doesn't work for you. Your sweat moisturizes you.
Would you rather get back with an ex friend or an ex boyfriend? Like a snake, one of the snakes. Both of them are snakes. Would you rather get back with an ex friend or an ex boyfriend?
Oh my god. With an ex boyfriend, benefits can come with that. It doesn't say how long it has to last. With an ex friend, what the hell is the benefit? We already have too much negative history. Thanks, boyfriend.
I can take your eggs back. I want to get back with you. Ugh. That freaking pride.
Ugh. How do you do it? How do people do it? Would you rather meet George Washington or the current president? I literally don't care about either. Obama.
I'd rather meet Obama because,
period.
What is
your skin? Self-explanatory. Would you rather have X-ray vision? So like you sitting right here, you can see anything, period. Or have magnifying hearing, you can hear every conversation.
Magnifying hearing.
Would you rather be able to like see in the future?
No, never.
I know that's fucked up.
Never.
See in the future or read minds?
Whatever reminds. I would never want to see a picture.
Yeah. Cause what are you living for?
Yeah, what are you living for?
What are you literally living
what
for?
What if someone's gonna, I know someone's gonna die. How do I act normal around them? How do I?
You can't be going around telling everybody when they're gonna fucking die. No one wants to know that shit.
No one wants to know.
I imagine finding out when you die, how you die.
But then like always reading someone's mind can really drain you. As a
yeah.
Person. So either way, it really sucks.
Sometimes but you really need fucking deception in your life. You yeah. need to not know what somebody's thinking.
Yeah.
What is in a relationship if you can't read their minds? It wouldn't work for me because I get my feelings hurt easily.
Yeah, me too.
I would get butt hurt.
I'm very sad. It's very sad, but I'm very sensitive. My dad sends me to my room too hard, I'm crying in my room. He said every time that he sends me to my room too hard, like, clean your room. I'll come here and cry just because he said it so mean, it would make me cry. Like, I'm just very sensitive.
I get my feelings hurt easily. How dare you think it? You must not love me.
You know, would you rather a 2-inch penis or a big man titties? Like a big
my
man.
My dad could never see this video.
Wait, a 2-inch was like so. No one see his wear a bra. Big, like he's fit, but he's a big.
First of all, look at my chest. Muscular men alone have just bigger boobs than me. Period. They're pecs. He has titties. He needs to play with himself. Cause what am I to him? A joke. He has breasts.
Or 2-inch penis. Like he was a beat. People said, oh my god. Legit boobs.
He's a man.
He's a man.
So he's big as hell.
Yeah, man. He's a man. But
I love this question. Because I'm not discriminating. We're not fat shaming over here. But big as fuck. Or
what's the easy question?
2 inch. If Drake had a 2 inch, I'd still be with him. I would still be with him. If Aubrey.
So wait, so you care about people thinking about your man?
If Drake had a 2 inch, I'd still be with him.
So you care about people thinking about your man?
Not about what people think about him. It's how I think about him. I couldn't find my attractive. But you love big titties in my face, and I know I ain't got shit. That's crazy.
But you love when women kiss their nails. You love when men kiss each other. But you don't. You want to have a little bit of boobs?
I don't love when men kiss.
No, you do. She loves it. She loves it. She loves it.
I don't love when.
She loves when guys put their nails. She loves when guys kiss each other. She loves when guys are a little bit romantic with each other.
When you say I love when guys kiss each other, you know how people see that? That's crazy.
She loves me.
I broke this down.
She has a husband. He's the best friend. She would like to see a little peck. Before they leave.
Maybe not on the lip.
Her ass slap. She looks a little ass slap.
It's playful. I love when.
So, your dad. You want to see your dad kiss a man?
That's different.
No, it's not.
I love when men aren't too caught up in their masculinity. When a man can just be a man.
Of course.
And be okay.
Of course.
I love when
she was in a. Bye. See you later.
Love you. I love if they.
No!
I love if they're able to play around like that. I love when men aren't too caught up in their masculinity, because then it's just like, bro, you can't do anything.
Of course. But when it comes to giving a custom look before they go,
that's playful. I'm not talking about like an everyday thing. I'm not talking like an everyday thing.
So when you see it for the first time, you're not gonna be like, ah! What the fuck is that? You see that shit for the first time.
How am I jealous of Brad? Like,
you just kissed another day.
Please.
You would never feel anything.
If Playboy Cardi, if Drake had a 2 inch.
Yo! Inches. 2 inches is this. This is about approximately 1 inch. This is, that's a tampon. That's a tampon. That's a tampon.
I'm a lesbian.
You can translate to be a lesbian? They feel natural love. That's it for this video.
I didn't mean it.
Thank you guys so much for watching.
I'm not homophobic. I didn't mean it.
If you guys like this video, you guys
love
to
do. Love is legitimate. Love is love.
And if you guys like this video, you guys want to do, comment, subscribe, like this video, whatever. This is just us in our natural form. You know, we're not dressed up or anything, whatever. We're eating, having a good time, laughing, blah, blah, blah. If you guys like this, go over to our channel. We'll be doing a video over there. And it's going to be kind of like a girl talk. So if you guys want to listen to like anything.
Periods, delving into it.
Anything like that, just go over her channel, and I'll see you guys in the next video.